Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Vplay. And in today's video, we're going to have a look at all the helmets that are available in the game from class 1 to class 6. So I will go in detail with all of these classes in this video. So with that out of the way, let's go ahead and get started with the video. First, we are going to look at class 1 helmets. It has the lowest armor class in game, doesn't actually stop bullets and can be worn strictly for ricochet chance. Includes the TACKEC Fast MT, tanker helmet and a shattered mask. The first is the TACKEC Fast MT, which is a class 1 armor for 40 durability and a high ricochet chance. Unarmored helmet worn mainly for ricochet chance and can be used with a slap plate. It is compatible with an NVG and headset and available in the market for around 15,000 rubles. You can attach accessories, which is the ear armor from Peacekeeper level 3. You can use a mandible from Peacekeeper level 3, a face shield, a visor and a slap plate from Peacekeeper level 4. Next is the class 2 helmet, which is extremely minimal protection. And this helmet option available reduces hearing and the face shield are not worth using. Generally best to avoid them altogether, or you can use it while playing as scavs. So this includes a coal pack, a riot helmet and a firefighter helmet. Next is the class 3 helmet, the first useful class of head armor, and can stop basic pistol round, shotgun shells and low tier rifle ammo. Generally cheap and cost effective head armor. And this includes the 6B47 SSH helmet, Kiewer M, Ronin mask, the LSZH and Antar. So the first one is the SSH steel helmet. It is an armor 3 helmet with 30 durability. It has a high ricochet chance. Cheap, reliable helmet available for level 1. Ricochet chance makes it worth using and it is compatible with all the headsets. It is available from Ragman level 1 for around 21,000 rubles. It has no accessories that you can attach to it currently. Next one is the 6B47 Ratnik helmet. It is a class 3 armor with 25 durability and a high ricochet chance. It has better coverage than the SSH helmet and a good ricochet chance as well. It is compatible with NVGs and headsets as well. It is available from Ragman level 2 for around 33,000 rubles, like Ragman level 1 for 2 bleach and Ragman level 2 for around 7 dog tags. There are no equipments that you can attach to it, and you can also attach a night vision mount onto it. So Kiewer M helmet, it is a level 3 helmet with 35 durability and 40 durability for the face shield. It has a medium ricochet chance, useful as the early game option for face shield as it is the only one available in the first slot of the game. It is not compatible with NVG or headsets as well, as it can reduce hearing also. It is available from Ragman level 2 for around 33,000 rubles. And for the accessory, you can only use the Kiewer M face shield from Ragman level 2 for around 27,000 rubles. Next one is the LZHS helmet, which is a class 3 helmet, 35 durability for the helmet, 40 durability for the face shield, and it has a medium ricochet chance. Somewhat expensive for class 3, but can be used for higher level attachments as well. It is compatible with the NVG and the headsets also. It is available from Ragman level 2 for around 53,000 rubles. For the accessories, you can attach a ear armor from Peacekeeper level 3, a mandible from Peacekeeper level 3, face shield and a visor from Ragman level 2. For the class 4 armor, it is the largest selection of helmets and can stop most of the pistol round, shotgun shells and low to mid tier rifle ammos. Lot of options for face shields and attachments. It includes the ACHHC, ULAC, MIC, TC-800, LSHZ, Fast MT, Cry Airframe, Exfil, Masca and Bastion. So the first one is the MIC TC-2001-2002. It is a class 4 armor with 25 to 27 durability. It has a high ricochet chance. The first class 4 helmet which is unlocked and decent overall stats for a fair price. Compatible with NVGs and Comtex as well. It is available from Peacekeeper level 2 or 3 for around $420 to $450. The accessories, you can attach a slab plate from Peacekeeper level 4 for around $850, and it is also available from the flea market for around 90,000 rubles. Next one is the Striker ACHHC, which is a class 4 armor with 30 durability and it has a high ricochet chance, very similar to the TC2001, slightly higher durability and similar price. Compatible with Comtax and no NVG mounts, available from Ragman level 3 for around 56,000 to 59,000 rubles, and it has no available attachments to it. Next is the Striker Ulac, which is the class 4 armor with 38 durability and it has a high ricochet chance as well. It has direct upgrade from the ACHHC helmet, adding an ear armor, and the tan version is very cost effective as well. It is compatible with Comtax and no NVG mounts are available. It is available from Ragman level 4 for around 66,000 to 84,000 rubles. 66 is for the tan helmet and the 84,000 is for the black one. It has no available attachments to it. Next is the OPS Core Fast MT. This is a class 4 armor with 40 durability and high ricochet chance. It is also good with good in durability and stats, and ton of mods are available, but it is a little expensive from the other helmets. It is compatible with NVG and headsets as well, and it is available from Ragman level 3 for around 140,000 rubles, from Peacekeeper level 3 for around $1,200. For the accessories, it has the ear armor, mandible, face shield, visor and the slab plate from Peacekeeper level 4. Next is the MSA TC800. It is a class 4 armor with 30 durability and a high ricochet chance, very similar to the Fast MT but less durable, cheaper and has less mods to it. It is also compatible with NVGs and headsets, available from the flea market for around 60,000 to 80,000 rubles, it fluctuates a lot. Accessories, it has face shield from Peacekeeper level 4 for around $330 and the visor for around $1,200. Next is the Cry Airframe Tan Helmet, which is a class 4 armor for 40 durability, high ricochet chance, very similar to the Fast MT, but different mods allow 2 layers of face protection. Compatible with the NVGs and the headsets, and it is available from Peacekeeper level 4 for around $1,200. For the accessories, you can attach a face shield and ear armor and chops as well for 1 GPX. Next is the Team Wendy X-Fill, which is a class 4 armor for 45 durability and a high ricochet chance, slightly more durable version of the Fast MT, but has a better face selection, face shield option. It is also compatible with the NVG and the headsets. The availability is from Peacekeeper level 4 for around $1,200, or you can buy it from Peacekeeper level 3 for around 10 dog tags as well. For the accessories, you can use the face shield from Peacekeeper level 4 and your armor from Peacekeeper level 4 as well. Next is the Fast MT Clones, which is similar to the Fast MT but are better performance in terms of overall performance onto it. So you can use the TC800 airframe, the X-Fill and the Fast MT are all viable options but are a little expensive. So recommended setups is Fast MT with a slab plate, airframe with chops and shield, X-Fill with ears plus shield and TC800 with face shield. You can also use the ballistic face shield from Peacekeeper level 4 for around $290. You can use the X-Fill face shield. You can use the airframe chops, which is only available from 1 GPX. And you can also use the slab plate from Peacekeeper level 4. Next is the Diamond Age Bastion, which is a class 4 armor with 40 durability and a high ricochet chance. It is similar to the Fast MT, much cheaper and with a class 6 extra armor attachment. It is compatible with NVG and headsets, available from the flea market for around 50,000 to 60,000 rubles. For the accessories, you can add an additional armor which is available for 100,000 plus in the flea market. Next is the ZHS-12M, which is a class 4 armor for 30 durability and 50 face shield durability. It has a medium ricochet chance, relatively budget class 4 helmet plus shield option, and the black version is very affordable. For the availability, it is from Lagman level 3 for around 40,000 to 60,000 rubles, and the black version is available after Chemical Part 4 quest. For the accessories, you can get a face shield for it. Next is the LSHZ-2DTM, which is a class 4 armor with 55 durability and 50 durability for the face shield and has a high ricochet chance as well. It is relatively strong in overall stats and a class 4 face shield, but a high price makes it less worthwhile. And it is compatible with the NVG, and the availability is with Ragman level 3 for around 150,000 rubles. You can attach a face shield onto it. You can also use the event tail from Ragman level 4 and a camo cover from Ragman level 3 as well. The event tail adds a class 5 armor to the back of your head, which gives you extra protection from behind. Next is the Maska ISCH, which is a class 4 armor for 60 durability and 50 durability for the face shield with medium ricochet chance. It is a very strong face shield, but the helmet itself is not that great, and it has bad visibility with the face shield as well. You can also buy it from Ragman level 3 for 5 GP coins, and a unique version is only available from the Scav Boss Killer. The accessories, you can use the Maska face shield from Ragman level 4 for around 3 GP coins as well. Next is the newly introduced Galvin Camion Ballistic Helmet, which is class 4 and has 50 durability as well and a high ricochet chance. This is the newest class 4 helmet which is unlocked in the 12.8 update, and it is decent overall stats but a little expensive on the parts. It is compatible with headsets, and the NVG slot is also available if the visor is not installed. In the market it is available for around 60,000 to 85,000 rubles as it fluctuates a lot. For the accessories, you can use the Ballistic Guard Mandible, which is available from Peacekeeper level 3, a fixed arm visor, and a hybrid ballistic apicule from Peacekeeper level 4 for around $547. Next is the class 5 armor. There are only two helmets available in this particular armor, which is the Alten and the Reyes T, which was currently introduced in the 12.8, and it can stop all pistol rounds, shotgun shells, and most mid-tier rifle ammos. It is largely considered the strongest PvP helmet class for close range fights also. It includes the Alten and the Reyes T. For the Alten, it has 45 durability and 50 durability for the face shield. It has a high ricochet chance as well, and great armor for the entire head hitbox. Only disadvantage is the weight, visibility, and no headsets are allowed. The availability is from Ragman level 4 for around 6 R pliers, 5 pliers, and 5 M tapes, or you can get it from the flea market for around 100,000 rubles. For the accessories, you can use a face shield from Ragman, which is available for 4 plexiglass, 6 dog tags, or 3 face shields. For the Reyes T, it has 50 durability for the helmet, 55 durability for the face shield, and it also has a high ricochet chance. It is better than the Alten in terms of overall durability, but it has the same disadvantages. The availability is from Ragman level 4 for 5 armored, 6 plexiglass, and 1 cordura. You can also use it with a face shield, which is available only from Ragman level 4 for 4 plexiglass plus 1 bolt. Next and the last one is the class 6 helmet, which is the Vulcan, which is the only option available. It can stop all pistol rounds, shotgun shells, and most rifle ammos. But technically it is very strong, but the Vulcan is crazy expensive and the face shield is only level 4, which is quite less. So the Vulcan face shield is a class 6 armor with 55 durability for the helmet and 85 durability for the face shield. It is very strong, but the weight, price, and the class 4 face shield makes it less worthwhile. So even if somebody hits you with a $3 bullet, you can go down very quickly, even though if you're wearing a $400,000 helmet. So I really don't feel that it is worth the $400,000 price tag, which is available from Ragman level 4 for around 400,000 rubles. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like button and to subscribe to my channel as I come up with more guide videos every week. If you have any suggestions or corrections about this video, don't forget to write them down in the comment section below, and I will see you in the next one.